Hello and welcome to Let's Play Midnight Scenes, The Nanny, which is the third game in the Midnight series, the Midnight Scenes series by Octavi Navarro. Hopefully I'm saying that right. It was released in 2021, October to be exact, and I believe it's $3 or $4 on Steam. Which is $4 on Steam. $3.99, I believe, at this time. The options are not much. We got volumes and language you can't change. I put the volume way down because so you can hear me. Hopefully that'll be sufficient. So these are very short horror adventure games. I read all the things, so I'm going to be reading all the text, as I did in the other two games. The eye showed up in the second game, so it's back now. The narrator of the story. I guess it's Rod Serling's eye. Maybe. On tonight's episode, two innocent children will face their most primal fears, haunted by mysteries from beyond the grave. Ancient secrets that should never have been unearthed, tormented souls wandering between realities. Turn off the lights and enjoy this chilling tale. Welcome to another dimension. Welcome to Midnight Scenes. Why, thank you. So I do like these little games. It's like good for me to just throw them in here and there where I have space. Gaps between other series I'm doing. I think it keeps everything a little diversified. Because I play a lot of long games, RPGs. October 1986. And the graphics, to me, looked the best so far out of any of the three games. Tina saying, "Good morning, my name's John Wilson. And I'm playing this blind. This is as far as I've played. I haven't gone beyond this." Good morning. Wait a second. I am John Wilson. What are you talking about? You must be a double. A double? Are you crazy? Doubles don't exist. Really? Then how do you explain this? Oh no, you're a doppelganger. My evil double, aren't you? Are you here to kill me and steal my identity? I don't want to die so young. Ah. Oliver says, "Are you coming to say goodbye to Mom and Dad?" "I'm busy." Alright, so we're playing as Oliver then. "They're going to be away for 3 days. Won't you miss them?" I was going to read it again. "Why should I? They're leaving me alone with you and that silly Veronica for 3 days. Guess that's the nanny. I hate them. Veronica is nice. I like her." "That's because you don't have any personality." "What are you playing, anyway?" "I still can't believe they bought me another identical Benny for my birthday. They don't care about me at all. They don't even remember what toys they've already given me. It's so funny. We got, like, dialogue choices. "Can I have one of them?" "No way. I'd rather keep playing this stupid doppelganger thing for the rest of my life." "Tina, leave me alone." To the garden clock. Was this for inventory, I guess? Painting. Ah, suitcases. To put the Elysian in. See the last episode? The M&M stain is still there. Your M&M's made a stain? You got me. Support your indie devs. I like the music. That's too funny. Oh, I want to look upstairs first. Veronica says, "Don't worry. If anything comes up, I'll call you right away. Have a great trip. The bay is beautiful this time of year." Dad says, "Wish we were going for pleasure, not work." Mom says, "We should go. The plane leaves in 3 hours, and we might hit some traffic. Hope you don't end up with Richard in the Elysian. You'll be the spear." See that plane trip. Last episode. "Bye, kids. Be good. And don't push Veronica too hard." Push. That's weird. Weird thing to say. "Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad." Could I have gone upstairs or out in the garden before this whole scene happened? Veronica says, "Well, here we are. We still have a couple hours until dinner time. What would you like to do?" "Watch TV." "The Amazing Jesse Marks is about to start. I love that show." "Of course you do. TV is entertainment for dumb kids." Tina's saying that. Let's paint. Guess I have to find something that Tina agrees with. "I like to paint trucks that explode," and Tina says, "Your drawings are boring. You paint like a little baby." That's not true. I can't just walk. Tina, don't talk to your brother like that. "It's Christina. Only my family calls me Tina. I've taken care of you so many times. Don't you consider me family yet?" "Pfft. Don't be ridiculous." "Well, Oliver, it looks like your sister is in a mood today. Maybe she wants to tell us what to do." "Let's go to the forest." "The forest?" "On the other side of the lake." Yeah, it's super cool. We go there some afternoons with Mom and Dad. We cross the lake with the boat and have a picnic sometimes. Can we go, please? That way I can look for my toy truck. I lost it in the clearing the other day." I want to go back and see if we can go upstairs, though, and see what's up there. "Okay, fine. Just for an hour, and then we come back," Veronica says. "Yay! You pick up the oars," says Tina. "Sure." Oh, we're not only going in the forest, but on a lake. Okay. Now we can go upstairs? They went out that way. The M&M stain. Dad's office. Dad won't let us go in his office if he's not home. Well, he's not here, you see, you do it, is he? The Jordan's garden looks so empty since Thomas got sick. Tina's room? I better not go into Tina's room if I want to stay alive. Oh, is that poor thing what? Poor thing, it's dying. We not take care of our plants here? Miss Jenkins would send me home if I painted something like that. That's his room, so obviously we're going to be able to go in there. Jordan's garden again. Okay. Tiny room. Walkie-talkies. I'm eager to try out my new walkie-talkies. Well, grab them. Okay. I could bring them to the lake, the forest, stuff like that. There's a new starling nest in the big tree. The one-eyed Pete Island Monster is my favorite. Hello, my name. Looking forward to the premiere of Galaxy of Cats Part 2. Yeah, you would. Alright, we can't look at the other things. Grab your coat. No. Alright. It's the end here. Okay. That's a weird echoey footfalls. Okay. Oh, I didn't want to go up there. No. That's the oars. I can go back in. I just want to see if we would say something. Because in the last game... Oh, look at that. That's eerie, the way that comes down. He wouldn't go back into places once we had left the room. Oh. Got them. Rope, oars. Huh. So your hands are full now. The Jordan's trees are invading our garden. A hole. Sparkle hasn't come to eat in days. Who's Sparkle? Let's tie up. Yeah, those are creepy looking trees. What did that say? Two pier. Anything this way? Oh, it looks all distorted on the side. It's interesting. Veronica says, do either of you know how to row? I've never piloted a boat. Pilot a rowboat? Leave it to the professionals, Tina says. Veronica says, but it's safe, right? Don't be afraid, Oliver says. There are no monsters in the lake or anything like that. Just sit next to me and take my hand. Ugh, get in the boat, lovebirds, Tina says. Yeah, I was like, take your hand. We need to install the oars first. Install? There, they're installed. Veronica says, all aboard! To the edges of the screen, it's so funny. It's like a VHS type of VHS tape playback. Can I go find... Can I go look for my truck? It can't be very far. Tina says, you're always losing stuff. You'll lose your stupid head one day. Veronica says, okay, you can go, but don't walk too far away. I don't want to lose sight of you. What do you want now? Tina says. You were right, Oliver. This forest is beautiful. Veronica says. Alright, so we're looking for a truck. Otherwise, I guess we'd be looking for tree paintings. Is that like for enhanced playability? Two forest. Chocolate bar. Oh. That's meant to lure him in. Oh, there's a crow. Catch the crow. A drawing over there. People are so inconsiderate. You might want to eat that. Was another crow. Oh, another... a bunch of crows. Peoples! Okay. Ooh. Okay. That was interesting. It's another drawing. Oh. Look like candy wrappers in the middle. I don't know what this is supposed to signify. Tree stump. They say if you count the rings, you can read their age. Alright. 20? 30? Do we count the rings? Bones. The lovely bones. Some animal. Nothing to say about this, Oliver? Okay, then. What about this drawing? No? Alright. A rock. Rock and squirrel. Ooh. A worm on it? Worm's gone. Oh, it's eating someone's finger. Squirrels are herbivores. Any more Oliver-eyed crows? So we can't look at these other drawings. Sticks? Interesting. There's anything to say about some of this stuff. Mom never lets me play this far from the clearing. My truck must be around here somewhere. That must be it. Rock, truck. Here you are. Who put you there? A demon. Tina says, "Hey, Oliver, come here. There's something I want to show you." That's not really Tina. Tina? What are you doing here? It's not really her, man. Zoinks! Oh, she's still back over there with Veronica. So many squirrels in this forest, says Veronica. Tina says, one time they ate a kid from town, from head to toe. Only his bones remained. I'm not lying, it was on the news. That's creepy. By the way, where's your brother? I told him not to walk too far away. Don't ask me. I'm not the babysitter. Oliver! He's dead, with the truck shoved into his open, dead mouth. Oh boy! We've got something in suspended animation. A Neanderthal wraith. Oliver. Veronica says, Oliver! What's wrong? What the hell is that? Tina says, the forest is full of paintings like that. Oh, it's a painting? I thought it was inside this thing. Dad says there's this magical aura from the tribes that lived in the woods. It keeps the paintings bright. Well, that explains something, I guess. This one, though, I haven't seen it before. Veronica says, it certainly looks recent. So creepy. You didn't paint it to scare passersby, did you? How would I have painted it? It's like 20 feet tall. Oliver's not saying anything. Come on, it's time we go back home, says Veronica. I don't like this place. It gives me the creeps. Come on, Oliver, let's go. Oliver? Oliver! What's happening? Says Tina. Is he all right? No idea. Come on, help me get him to the boat. Picking him up or dragging him? Thank God you're back. How are you feeling? Veronica says. What happened? A blood sugar drop, probably. Here, eat this chocolate. Does he have diabetes? Well, chocolate keeps away Dementors. It's good. Hazel, that's my favorite. Really? Mine too. Hey, are you sure you're okay? Maybe I should call the doctor. How long was I unconscious? I just have questions. You've been in and out for about 10 minutes. You scared us to death. Oliver says, and Tina, where is she? In her room, I think. Her door's cracked open. I wonder what she wanted to show me, says Oliver. What do you mean? In the woods, she told me to follow her. Oh yeah, it wasn't really her. I tried, but she walked too fast. Then I found that strange drawing on the rock. It really impressed you, huh? Says Veronica. Isn't Veronica gonna say she didn't do that? I don't know. I guess. Come on, rest while I heat up dinner. What? Veronica's supposed to be saying, well, Tina didn't go in the forest and meet you. She was with me the whole time. The lasagna I brought will surely bring you back to life. Yeah, why isn't she saying that to him? Like, Tina didn't run through the forest. She just sat there with me and then we went to go look for you. Looks like dinner did wonders. I like that happy, rosy face. Now rest, little prince. Have sweet dreams. Don't listen to her. Don't listen to her, says Oliver. What? Tina, she's always mean, but I think you're cool. Oh, thank you very much. I think you're cool, too. I really enjoy taking care of you both, you know? You're very interesting kids. Hey, do you want me to show you my collection of cards? It's from the Midnight Zombies TV series. Sure, I'd love that. He's gonna make a move on her. Scared zombie. This one is the biggest and scariest zombie of the family, but he's always nice to the living. Really? This is a zombie family. So he's the scariest, but he's also scared. Next card, okay. Baby zombie? Don't be fooled. Even though it's a baby, this one has super sharp teeth. This is the stupidest TV show I've ever heard of. Hungry zombie. This one's the most evil. She devours brains. Okay. Zombie pet? And this is my favorite. Isn't she cute? Why doesn't it say zombie dog? What a fantastic collection. I love it. Hope you don't dream of brain-eating zombies tonight. Get some rest, Oliver. Good night. Night. He's doomed. Oh. Back to the Wraith. The Wraith painting. Oliver! Tina says, Oliver! Hey, Oliver! Are you awake? What do you want? Let me sleep. It's Veronica. She's gone. She left us. stop. You're always trying to scare me. Oliver says, if you don't stop, I'll tell Mom when she gets back. I'm telling you, I saw her from my window. She was walking toward the pier. She must be meeting her boyfriend secretly, when she should be here taking care of us, like that other time. You made that up. You never liked Veronica, Oliver says. I didn't make it up. That boyfriend of hers jumped over to our garden to be with her. I saw them kissing. Ew, says Oliver. But this time I have my camera, Tina says. I'll take pictures. Come on, let's see if we can spy on them from the window. Yeah, it would be a camera. Otherwise, she'd just use her cell phone. Because it is 1986. There were no cell phones. See something? Oliver says. The boat is missing. They've gone to the other side of the lake. How romantic. How? She doesn't even know how to steer the boat. More proof that she's with her boyfriend. I can see a light in the forest, but nothing more. Dad has the old binoculars in his office. And you want me to go get them, of course. I have to keep watch in case they come back. Come on, they must be on his desk or in a drawer, or maybe in the closet. Take care of my truck, will ya? Hurry up and go get the binoculars. The garden is full of crows. I've never seen so many. So let's see if he says something different. Alright. Can we see anything out this window? What a starry sky. Should I check downstairs first? Just for the hell of it. Hello? Veronica? Tina wasn't lying. She left us. Oh boy! Easter egg. It's backwards. Cool. Backwards masking. It's still hot. Veronica must have left very recently. He wants to sniff the couch so he can sniff her. Never mind. The binoculars are in Daddy's office, not in the garden. Don't you talk to me like that, young man. Fascinating. Big painting. I couldn't look at this before, could I? Modern art. Yuck. Yeah, I don't remember getting a thing for that. Two Street. I don't want to go outside now. Yeah, I couldn't look at this or the door before. Let's go back upstairs and into his office. It's like an echoing, fading thing. Lights. Okay, good. Dad would be mad if I found out I've been snooping around his office. Oh, he's not here. Get a grip. Trophies. 1967 and 1975. Football and basketball? That crow is staring at me. Drawer. Phone. Closet. I don't need to call anyone. It's locked. Alright, so the key is in there and the binoculars in there, I'm betting. Small key, army tag. What do you call it? Writing paper? I wonder if Dad killed someone in the war. Maybe I'll ask him when he comes back. Then he'll know you were in his office looking at his dog tags. Got the small key. Oh. I don't know if we want to be answering that. Of course we're going to. Hello? Who is it? I think it's Harry Potter, speaking parcel tongue. Veronica, please come back. Why did you leave us? You're supposed to talk before you hang up the phone. Stationary. That's the word I was looking for. Writing papers? Is that what I call them? It's like some kind of stationary. I can drag it. A shoebox. Where is he walking to? Okay. A condom. Okay. I got photographs. These are from when I was born. Is his mother missing an eye? I like Veronica, but Miss Marquez was a super cool nanny. Is that the nanny? Or the mother? Oh, it's the nanny. She had this eye patch like Blackbeard. I miss her. She never would have left us. Okay. Nice picture, very good. Okay, here they are. So we don't... What's this? So squishy! It's another one! Is this one? We can't look at that one. Okay. Alright, we can't look at anything else in here, so... Alright, got binoculars. What if I use them on these windows? Oh, we don't care about that. Okay. Oh, we can't even use it on that window. Tina? I thought she... The way she was standing there, I thought she wasn't her again. Finally! Come on, give me the binoculars! No way! I got them! It's my turn to look! Got that right. Alright, we got crows. That way is probably towards that painting. I see Veronica. She's alone and looks confused. She actually looks scared out of her mind.